Over the 17 years of YouTube's lifespan, there have been some absolute legends come on the platform and make an insane name for themselves. You got Ray William Johnson, Jax Films, Jenna Marbles, Ryan Higa, to name some of the old school legends of YouTube. The gaming community has probably been YouTube's crown jewel for its 17-year lifespan, and some of those legends consist of Jacksepticeye, Markiplier, and even PewDiePie, to just name a few of them, that have absolutely ruled the roost when it comes to gaming on YouTube. They've revolutionized basically anything that you see gaming related. If you turn on a gaming video from your favorite YouTube channel, they've probably taken influence from PewDiePie, Jack, Markiplier, or really anybody that did it back in the early 2010s. But throughout the past couple of days, YouTube's golden boy has been under fire for something. I think it's probably the dumbest reason of all time to be canceled and be under fire. People just like to light the fire and watch it rage into a blazing inferno on the name of stirring the pot of stew. The golden boy in question is Markiplier, the crown jewel of gaming. He's YouTube royalty. He's the king of gaming, some may say. The prince of creativity, or even the CEO of Five Nights at Freddy's. But we can't actually get into why Markiplier is being canceled without taking it back a couple of years and discussing one of his very close friends, another legend in the gaming community. Absolutely wonderful year. It was the follow-up to 2016, a revolutionary year for just about everything. And what a year for comedy, may I add, in 2017. But what happened in 2017 that was just so important to this whole story of why Markiplier is being canceled? Get out your highlighter, because I'm taking you back to that very fateful day in September of 2017 where PewDiePie decided to take a walk on a bridge, got into a fight, lost, and said a word that you shouldn't say. This is a day that will probably forever live in YouTube infamy, as PewDiePie got absolutely slammed on every platform known to man for this incident. YouTube, Twitter, mainstream websites, even news channels were telling their story on the PewDiePie N-word situation, and it got bad for him for a little bit. This isn't where the controversy ends for PewDiePie though, as fast forward a couple months prior to February of 2017. Back in February of 2017, he did a YouTube video where he went on to Fiverr, a website where people can set up their own shops and services for you to pay them to do, like make thumbnails, edit videos, whatever. And he would pay these people to provide their service for him. One of these people that he found was a pair of dudes living in the jungle that would write whatever, and I emphasize whatever, you wanted on a piece of white poster board and hold it above their head in the jungle. And PewDiePie, bless his curious little soul, decided to test the limits of whatever and told them to write something that I won't say on the YouTube video, but I will show a blurred out version of it right here. Yeah, you can probably fill in the redacted blanks. After he posted this video, it got a lot of backlash, similar to the bridge. But this kind of backlash was a little bit worse than what he got for the bridge incident. Not only did he go under fire and get slammed by everything that I said earlier, but he actually got his YouTube Red show canceled. Basically, YouTube Red was a part of YouTube back in the day where different creators would get their own TV show and they would be produced through YouTube. He got scaring PewDiePie canceled, as well as his contract with Disney. So at this point, he was under extreme fire, and there was a blaze burning under his tail. Quite literally a burning blaze under his tail of controversy. So how does this accumulation of PewDiePie's wrongdoings and controversy lead us down the dark and deep rabbit hole that leads us straight to Markiplier? Mark stood up for him. Shortly after the controversy of PewDiePie making those people write that on the whiteboard and hang it above their heads, Markiplier made a response video simply titled Respect. Again, as you can see, this was 6 years ago. This was February of 2017. 6 years and a month, may I add. In this video, he would go into how people are kind of muffling the term respect, and it's kind of losing its original meaning, and people are forgetting what respect actually means. This video, all in all, was a direct response response to the fire lit under PewDiePie's tail following the Fiverr video. This was not just a video about respect, it was a response to people's response to PewDiePie about the video and how they're not giving him proper respect that he deserves even through this controversy. He discusses that humans naturally make mistakes. It's built into us, it's how we work, it's how we maneuver. And Felix made a human error. He made a mistake. He goes into labels and labeling somebody as something and how the media has labeled PewDiePie as many different things and how we shouldn't just attach those labels to him forever. People were calling him anti-Semitic and I'll probably bleep that out because I don't want this video to get blocked or restricted anywhere. But he basically went on to say that these labels that people are calling him are just dumb and they shouldn't define PewDiePie as a person at all. Labeling somebody as such can quite possibly ruin their life forever and in turn ruin every opportunity for them. PewDiePie is a human and Markiplier acknowledges the fact that he made a severe mistake by making those people write that on the whiteboard. This video at the time, of course, had a little backlash, as this entire situation is gonna, of course, draw some backlash to anybody's opinion on it. But it was overall respected by the people that watched it and viewed it because Markiplier's remarks in the video were respectful, hence the title of the video. That is until now, 6 years and 1 month later, following the controversy of PewDiePie. For whatever reason, the topic of PewDiePie being anti-Semitic and racist is coming back up in the conversation, but it's not through the lens of PewDiePie himself. And I'll get to that in a second, but if you've been following PewDiePie at all recently, he's a changed man. And of course, the labels handed to him back then are just not true now, because that is not the kind of person that Felix is anymore. What's lighting the fire under Markiplier's tail is indeed that video made defending PewDiePie. Now, why in the heck is this being brought back up now, 6 years later? I don't know. I really don't know. Something that I could pinpoint that could spark interest in Markiplier is him making an OnlyFans. And that sparked interest in him because, of course, people are like, Markiplier's making an OnlyFans? The gaming guy is making an OnlyFans? So it got people talking, at least. But then again, I really don't know the exact reason why this is being brought back up now. If you know, tell me in the comments because I may have not done further research enough. But people are coming after Markiplier for defending PewDiePie back when all this was happening, and they're also mad at him for simply being associated with PewDiePie. As we all know, they've made countless videos together. They were very popular at the time, so why not collaborate? Especially back in the 2015 through 17 era, they were very close friends and filmed together frequently. Obviously, nowadays, it's been a very long hiatus in time between the last time they filmed the video and now, but I'm sure they're still on good terms. But for right now, they've not filmed in a long time. So the term associated with PewDiePie is simply not true in 2023. People are coming after Markiplier for defending an anti-Semite, or defending an anti-Semitic, or defending a racist. All that Mark was saying was, people make mistakes. Humans are humans, and no one is perfect. People have even gone as far as saying that Markiplier himself is anti-Semitic and racist, which I just don't get. It completely baffles me why people would even go that extent to call him out for such a thing. Mind you, this was 6 years ago. This wasn't last week. This wasn't last month. This wasn't last year. This wasn't during the pandemic. This was 2017. I was 12. I'm almost 18 right now. This is how long ago this was. Felix right now is living in Japan with his wife, and he's about to have a child. I don't understand why people are going back and bringing up a 7.5 minute video simply defending the fact that we shouldn't be labeling somebody for making a human mistake. It doesn't make sense to me, and I think many sane people are probably saying the same thing. It just doesn't make sense. He was saying, don't pass judgment on people. Don't label them for something they're not because they made a mistake. Continue to respect people despite their wrongdoings. That's all Mark was saying in that video. He wasn't defending the anti-Semitic remarks. And by associating himself with Markiplier, he wasn't defending the racism. This has nothing to do with Markiplier. I think people were just finding a reason to come after him because they want to light a fire of stew. Markiplier in this situation is innocent, and people are just digging up minuscule pieces of information to put together a narrative that isn't true. They're giving him labels. They're canceling him. For what? I still don't know. But what do I think will happen with all this? I think it'll pass over. Mark's not going to get canceled. His fans will come to defend him. There's 33 million people on his side. I'm one of them. I know that most people out there are one of them. So this isn't going to go much farther than just a couple of tweets and maybe a YouTube video coming after Mark. But other than that, I think he's clean and the fire that's lit under his tail is going to be blown out. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.